Well, hello, Celebration family. Once again, we gather together around God's Word. Well, as you know, we have been talking about being citizens of the Holy City. And understanding who you are is important so that we would be able to prevail beyond the times. You see, our identity is tied to Christ, and once we understand who Jesus is and what his purpose was, and then listen to his word and apply it in our lives, we're able to see and understand and know our purpose. But the challenge is, we cannot do it in our own strength. We need the strength of God. That is, to be the witnesses that God has called us to be. In order to be those witnesses, we must begin by the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Once you are born again, once you are born of God, you need to be filled with the Spirit of God so that you might have the power to follow through and accomplish the Word of God, to see it manifested and lived out in your life. This is the same Spirit that rose Jesus from the grave. It is the same thing that Jesus had dwelling in him, the same person of the Holy Spirit. And this witness that God has given us is to progressively grow and increase in our lives. It begins at home. When you first come to Christ, your witness begins at home. The people closest to you, the people who know you the best, those are the people who will be watching you and looking to see if God has really done something in your life. And we see this important principle established here in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, where Jesus says, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you shall be my witnesses both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and even to the remotest parts of the earth." This is where we must begin to pursue the Lord. We must be able to experience this empowering of the Holy Spirit. It is that anointing and that unctioning of the Spirit of God that enables you to actually follow through and accomplish the will of God. We know that good intentions are good for nothing, but it's important to have follow-through and accomplishment in our lives. We need to be able to accomplish, to do the will of God. Even God himself has given us in the scripture, he says that we are to be doers of the word and not just hearers only, as James has noted. And so you and I must be able to accomplish the will of God by the same Spirit that rose Christ from the dead, that is the power of the Holy Spirit. And so we can see this kind of modeled for us in the life of Gideon as we look here in Judges chapter 6, verses 25 to 27. It says, "Now on the same night the Lord said to him, 'Take your father's bull and a second bull, 7 years old, and pull down the altar of Baal, which belongs to your father, and cut down the Asherah that is beside it.'" And so here is God giving Gideon directions. Now Gideon has already had a conversation about his unworthiness and how he would not be able to fulfill the will of God and help lead the people of Israel to victory in battle. But because of his stance in the world, because of his family position, the fact that he was the youngest of all his brethren and that he was in a family that was the least among his people. But I tell you, when God has called you, it does not matter about any of those things. Whom God has called, he will empower, he will enable to accomplish his will for his purposes, that they and you may prevail beyond the times that they're in. And so here we see Gideon is able to prevail beyond his times because God has called him to do a work, and he follows through and he accomplishes. He does what God calls him to do. He tears down the altar of Baal and the Asherah that is beside it that belonged to his own father. And this is where our witness must begin. It must begin at home with our own families. We must be able to make a stand for the kingdom of God. In verse 26, it says, "And build an altar to the Lord your God on top of this stronghold in an orderly manner." and take a second bull and offer a burnt offering with the wood of the Asherah, which you shall cut down. And so God is giving all of this direction and all of these instructions to Gideon. And Gideon's sole purpose is to obey, to apply these principles, to actually follow through and do what God is telling him to do. This is what you and I must also do. We must learn how to hear the Lord and follow him, obey him, apply his principles and his word, do what God has called us to do. In verse 27, it says, "Then Gideon took 10 men of his servants and did as the Lord had spoken to him. And because he was too afraid of his father's household and the men of the city to do it by day, he did it by night." And so we see that he was able to accomplish this plan that God had called him to do. He didn't just believe it. He didn't just receive it, but he applied it and he accomplished it. He did the will of God. You and I must learn how to do the will of God. This is what the Spirit of God will enable us to accomplish when we have received the Spirit of God, when we have been endued with power from God. In fact, he pulled down the altar of Baal. And we know that Baal was the sun god and the storm god. He was the supreme male deity that the ancient Phoenicians worshipped and the Canaanites worshipped and those in the Mesopotamian region. And he was a very popular god that we see over and over again in scripture. And the Asherah was the moon goddess, and she was the principal female deity that was also worshipped during those times by the Syrians and Phoenicians and Canaanites as well. And so the Israelites were caught up in all of these false idols and false gods and all of these things, and God says, tear them down. You and I must learn how to tear down the idols in our own house. We must learn how to cause those who are living in our under our roofs, those who are under our influence, those who are our own blood and family members, we must be the witness that God has called us to be. We must be able to stand against the challenges of the enemy. We must be able to prevail beyond the times. In verse 28, it says, "When the men of the city arose early in the morning, behold, the altar of Baal was torn down, and the Asherah, which was beside it, was cut down. And the second bull was offered on the altar, which had been built." In other words, they tore down those altars and they built the altar of God on top of that. And this is what you and I are doing. It doesn't matter what your past has been. It doesn't matter what your family history is. We are building a new altar, an altar unto God. We are making the change. We are the change agents and those who are bringing the transition of the kingdom of God as the people of God, that we may prevail beyond these times, overcoming every strategy of the enemy, every work of Baal and of Asherah that still exists today. You and I are a people who must be able to stand in full representation of the kingdom of God by the power of the Spirit of God who dwells within us. In verse 29, it says, "They said to one another, who did this thing? And when they searched about and inquired, they said, Gideon, the son of Joash, did this thing." And so it had gone out that after it was all determined and searched out, that Gideon was the man who had done this. And I'm sure Gideon was afraid. We know he was afraid because he did it at night so that no one would see him. In verse 28, it says, "When the men of the city arose, that they saw that this was all torn down, and they were wondering who did this thing. And so they found out that it was Gideon. And when they found out it was Gideon, they said in verse 30, then the men of the city said to Joash, bring out your son, that he may die, for he has torn down the altar of Baal, and indeed he has cut down the Asherah which was beside it." Oh, here he is, the guy who is the one who was hosting these false gods and these altars, his own son, his household, and the people came and they said, bring him out so that we can put him to death. And here is Joash, here is Gideon's father saying, hey, no. That's not going to happen. In verse 31, he says, Joash says to all who stood against him, will you contend for Baal or will you deliver him? Whoever will plead for him shall be put to death by morning. If he is God, let him contend for himself, because someone has torn down his altar. The saints of God, when you stand for God, God will cause even your enemies to be at peace with you. You will be able to make a stand for the kingdom of God because the Spirit of God will go before you. God will enable you. He will be your source and your shield. He will be the very one and the very thing that will sustain you and keep you no matter what your challenge may be. You need to operate in the power of the Holy Spirit under the strength of God so that you too can pull down the altars of Baal and the Asherah that is beside it in your life, in your family, in your lineage, that you might be the witness that God has called you to be. Verse 32 says, finally, therefore on that day he named him Jerubbaal. That is to say, let Baal contend against him because he had torn down his altar. You see, God wants to give you a new name, one that represents the victories that God has given you in your life through the enabling and the empowering of the Holy Spirit. I pray that the power of the Spirit of God has come upon you and that you know that you are called to be a witness, that you are called to be a testimony of the Lord, that your witness will begin at home, that you will be able to prevail beyond the times when you understand who you are in Christ, and that you are a citizen of the holy city, that you would be able to be effective and accomplish the will of God as the Holy Spirit of God empowers you as a witness of the kingdom of God in Jesus' name.